Man thinks he is the supreme conqueror of nature with all his intelligence and scientific inventions. But insects have taken complete possession of land and thoroughly mastered the world long before man made an attempt to get a foothold on this planet. Insects appeared on the earth 50 million years ago. Actually, man is the intruder and invader into the domain of insects. Insects depend upon almost the same plant and animal resources on which man also depends for its food, clothing, shelter, and other needs. When both man and insect species compete for the same resources at the same time, there will be a struggle between man and insects. Forbes in 1915 remarked, "The struggle between man and insects began long before the dawn of civilization. It has continued without cessation to the present time and will continue. No doubt, as long as the human race endures, insects for meeting their own food, shelter, and reproductive needs will continue to damage the plants and animals in a variety of ways. In turn, man through a number of ways strives to control and gain mastery over these insects. But man probably never can exterminate an insect species. At best, he can succeed in bringing down the insect population to manageable levels so that they can coexist together without seriously affecting the other's welfare. At present, the emphasis is on pest management rather than pest control. Coming to the types of damages caused by different harmful insects, there is hardly any plant that is not infested by some insects or the other. The factors that decide the importance of an insect as a pest species are the susceptibility of the crop and the nature of damage inflicted by the insect to the crop. Insects cause injury to plants either directly or indirectly to various portions of the plant, especially the roots, the stem, bark, shoots, leaves, bud, flowers, and fruits, which are attacked and damaged by the insects. This type of damage usually falls into two main groups, that is, the chewing insects and sucking insects damage. Insects which chew off external parts, grind them up and swallow them, they possess biting type of mouth parts and cause damage, such as they feed on growing parts of the plant and thus retard the growth. Especially the grapevine flea beetle Scelodonta strigicolis on grape. They feed on the leaves, defoliate the plants, causing reduction in the assimilative leaf area and thus hinder the plant growth. The semi-looper caterpillar on castor, the red-headed hairy caterpillar on groundnut, and the slug caterpillar on mango and castor are some examples. They notch the edge of the leaves, as in the case of ash weevils belonging to Milloceros species, which feed on a variety of crops like moringa, brinjal, cotton, bamboo, etc. And the grasshoppers like Aeroglypus banyan and Oxia species, which feed on rice and sugarcane. They also make small holes on the leaves by feeding. The flea beetle on radish and sunhemp can cause this type of damage. Some insects feed on the layer of surface of the leaf, example larvae of diamondback moth on cauliflower and cabbage, or superficially on the surface tissue, example grubs and adults of Epilacna beetle on brinjal. The leaves are riddled with large holes of irregular shape and size due to the feeding by the cabbage semilooper Trichoplusia knee. Roll-up of the leaves and feeding within is found in the case of larvae of Scilepta derogata on cotton. Some insect larvae feed on the bark of the plants or trees, living concealed in a protective covering of frass and excreta in a silken web, example bark-eating caterpillar Indarbella tetravonis on moringa, curry leaves and rain tree. They also cut the stem of tender plants at the time of germination, example surface weevil Atractogaster finitimus, which attacks similarly the seedlings of cotton raised under rain-fed conditions. Some insects feed on the flower buds and flowers, and cause reduction in the yield. Larvae of Maruca vitreta web the flower buds and flowers on red gram and feed on them. The adults of blister beetle feed on red gram and sesamenia, and sitonid beetle on rose feed on the flower buds and petals. Some insects nibble and cut off the earheads, example rice grasshoppers. Some eat partially the grains and give chalky appearance, as in the case of the damage inflicted by Helicorpa armigera to sorghum and ragi, otherwise called as finger millet. These insects remain outside and with their mouth parts pierce through the epidermis of the leaf and suck the sap. The following symptoms are kinds of damage which are caused by this mode of feeding. Many of sucking insects also at the time of feeding inject their salivary secretions due to the presence of certain toxins will cause further damage to the tissues of the plants. Most sucking insects attack the leaves of plants. A general chlorosis is caused by aphids and many of them cause ultimate withering and drying of the affected plants. The lab aphid, Aphis crassivora, which otherwise occurs on lab, the equivalent name for lab is aware, groundnut and glyricidia, wherein similar damages are also noticed. Small chlorotic areas near the midrib is a typical damage caused by mirrid bugs. Example, the sun hemp mirrid bug and the Barlaria tingit bug. Faint yellow speckling of leaves may be produced due to feeding, as in the case of castor whitefly and the coconut scale. Silvering or whitening of leaf surface due to removal of cell contents below the epidermis is the typical damage caused by thrips on onion, groundnut, etc. While feeding, spots are caused by tingit bugs like Stephanotis typicus on coconut and banana plants. Upper burn or necrotic brown lesions is the typical injury produced by leaf hoppers, example cotton and castor leaf hopper and rice brown plant hopper. Crinkling or curling of leaves is caused by insects like aphids, thrips and leaf hoppers, especially in chilies. Distortion of foliage and clustering of terminal shoots are found due to mealybug infestation on mulberry, glyricidia and crotons. Proliferation of leaf tissue as reddish patch at the site of feeding, example in case of whitefly Bemisia tabaci infestation on the undersurface of Acaranthus aspera. Premature shedding of developing fruits or dying of shoots as in scales and mealybugs infestation. Example, Sanjo's scale on apple, the rose scale on rose. Premature fruit fall is also observed in citrus due to fruit sucking moths which pierce the rind of the fruit. The internal feeders cause damage by remaining within the plant tissues under a part or all of their destructive stages. This is accomplished by the adults thrusting their eggs into the tissue by their ovipositor or by the larva eating their way in after they hatch from the eggs. Internal feeders could be borers, worms or weevils, leaf miners and gall insects. Coming to borers, when the larvae bore or feed on the wood or pith of the plant or part of the plant which may be generally large enough to contain the body of the pest, they are referred to as borers. The larvae may bore into the terminal shoots and cause death of the shoots, as in the case of cotton bollworm. Area species. In case of rice, the stem borer and sorghum stem borer, the larvae enter into the stem and cause death of the central shoots. An unique example of an adult beetle borer is that of coconut rhinoceros beetle, Oryctes rhinoceros, which bores into the tender fronds, biting the fibrous material. They are borers in flower buds and fruits including nuts and seeds. The larvae of worms or weevils bore into flower buds and cause shedding. Such larvae are usually called budworms, as in the case of moringa budworm and jasmine budworm. When the larvae, being very small, live in between the two epidermal layers of the leaves and feed on the food material inside, they are referred to as leaf miners. Some of the common examples are citrus leaf miner, cashew and mango leaf miner, and the buprestid leaf miner. In their immature or adult stages, certain insects are known to be responsible for formation of a special plant deformity known as gall, and these galls resemble tumors and they provide shelter and food to the insect. The nutritious sap secreted inside the galls is either absorbed through the body surface or sucked by the mouth parts. Due to the formation of galls, the growth of plants may be hindered and setting of fruits impaired, grains and seeds are also affected. So, subterranean means the insects which live below the surface of the soil. Insects which are found in soil live by feeding on the roots of plants and trees by chewing or biting or boring or sucking the sap or by forming galls. Many soil dwelling insects are host specific and most of them damage the crops in their larval stage, as in the case of wireworms, chaffers, cutworms, flea beetle, etc., and only a few spend their life cycle in the soil entirely. Though the damage caused to root may vary depending on the species and the crop that is affected. Generally, the attacked plants show stunting, discoloration, withering, and death of the plants. The insects cause injury to stored products in three different ways. Number one, it may be due to continuation of a field attack, as in sweet potato weevil and potato tuber moth. Secondly, the eggs may be laid in the field itself and the damage may occur in the storage, as in the red gram infested by brookid beetle. Third case, the infestation may continue from the material stored earlier and be carried over to the fresh material stored later in the godown or storage house, as in the case of grain weevil Psittophilus oryzae. The Psittophilus oryzae infests single grains and the floor moth Cadra cautella or Ifestia cautella, which webs together the grain with silken threads and feeds on them. Apart from this type of attack, the occasional damage to food material in stores by cockroach may also be considered. Coming to what are the indirect harmful effects of feeding by insects. Number one, making the harvest more difficult. Heavy incidence of some pests on crops makes the harvest of the crop more difficult. It may be very difficult to harvest cabbage or lab pods infested heavily with aphids or kapas from cotton bolls damaged by bollworms. Secondly, contamination and loss of quality of the produce. Due to insect attack, the final produce may show loss of quality by reduction in the nutritional value or in marketability. In some cases of cardamom, the berries infested by thrips become poor in quality due to scaly patches on the rind. The third type of indirect damage is dissemination of plant diseases. Insects in many cases are responsible for spreading many plant diseases which are caused by bacteria, fungi and viruses. Such insects are called as vectors. Though bacteria and fungi have alternative methods of dispersal, many plant viruses are mostly dependent upon their insect vectors for dissemination. About 99% of arthropod vectors are insects and 55% of these insects are aphids. Insects take a great deal of care in laying their eggs at the right place so that young ones will have sufficient food material for survival and development. By the act of oviposition, sometimes a few species of insects have been observed to inflict injury to crop in several occasions. It is a well-known fact that periodical cicada, also known as 17-year locust, slits the wood severely on the twigs of 1-year-old growth for egg-laying, as a result of which the portion beyond that egg-laying point dries up. In case of cow bugs or membracids, they insert eggs in rows into the tissue of tender stem and thus cause injury. Sometimes plant parts are used by insects for construction of the nests, though they do not feed on them. A striking example is the circular pieces of foliage from plants like rose, red gram, etc. by leaf cutter bee Megakyle anthracaena for nesting purpose. Similarly, tropical leaf cutting ants are known to strip off the leaves from the plants and trees and carry them to their nests. In case of red ant Ecophila smaragdina, the nest is constructed in the tree itself by webbing together large number of leaves. The third type of injury is injurious insects being carried from one plant to another. Ants and some kinds of insects, though they are not injurious to crops by themselves, often carry to other plants such injurious insects such as aphids, mealybugs, scales, etc. They care for and protect these insects so that they feed on the honeydew excreted by these pests. This mutual dependency of two organisms is often termed as mutualism. The insect pests of cattle and other domestic animals are mostly members of Diptera, and some are of Malophaga, Siphonculata and Siphonoptera. They attack cattle, sheep, goats and fowl. This variety of insect pests not only cause direct injury and annoyance to the animals, but in some cases transmit diseases and functional disorders in these animals. The productivity of affected animals is impaired and utility of farm animals is reduced, resulting in huge losses. Horsefly, Tabanus striatus, the female fly pierces the skin of animals and sucks the blood, which continues to ooze from the wounds even after the fly has left the animal. Stablefly Stomoxys calcitrans is usually abundant after rains. Both females and males suck blood from the cattle, horses and other animals including man, usually from his legs, and the legs engorged in 2 to 5 minutes and may feed as often as twice a day. Cattlefly Hippobosa maculata, it feeds on the blood continuously and produces seed-like puparia directly. Without laying eggs or larvae, the puparia drop to the ground and adult flies emerge in a week. The next one is the bow fly or blue bot fly, Lucilia species. The larvae attack open wounds and sores on the cattle body and feed on decaying tissues. It also bores into the flesh, causing cutaneous miasis and other internal complications in the cattle. Sand flies, Phlebotomus species, suck the blood and transmit Kala-Azar disease or leishmaniasis in human beings. Eye fly, Siphonculina funicola, over in front of the eyes and feed upon the secretions from the eye. Insects attack man in a number of ways. Some simply annoy him and some others directly injure him for his blood, while in a few the process transmit various kinds of diseases. The most common one is mosquito. Both sexes of mosquito feed on various juices of fruits and flower nectars, but it is the female mosquito which takes the blood meal after inflicting a painful bite on the human beings. Mosquitoes are vectors of 4 distinct human diseases: malaria, dengue fever, yellow fever and chikungunya fever. The principal vectors of malaria in India are Anopheles coulisifacius, Anopheles minimus, Anopheles sudanicus. Mosquitoes of the genus Aedes are responsible for transmission of the causative agents of important diseases such as dengue, yellow fever and chikungunya. Eye flies, these generally settle on the face, especially the corner of the eyes of a person, and it causes conjunctivitis in man. Black flies, the females are vivacious biters and suck blood mostly from cattle. Some species of black flies attack man. Bed bug, Simex hemipterus, the venom introduced by the bed bug bite causes itching, burning and swelling. They are parasitic on man and suck the blood. A large number of diseases transmitted by blood bugs are relapsing fever, typhus, Kala-Azar, plague and leprosy. They are which are suspected to be transmitted by bed bugs, but this has not been proved so far. Coming to fleas, fleas in their adult stage live as ectoparasites of warm-blooded animals. They infest dogs, cats, and human beings. Its bite is not felt at once, but becomes increasingly irritating and sore for several days. Bubonic plague and septicemic plague is the principal disease caused by rat flea Xenopsylla cheopsis. Human body louse and head louse can transmit relapsing fever, epidemic typhus, and French fever. They also cause lot of irritation by their bites. The skin of man becomes scarred, thickened, and bronze colored with brownish spots. The insects that are known to frequent our dwellings that fall accidentally into our eyes, those rest on the sensitive part of the body. Those that make irritating noise and those that damage our food materials, clothes, carpets, furniture, and books due to their biting and feeding cause annoyance. The following are some of these household pests. Ants. Some species build nests in sills and woodworks in the houses. They are pests on sugary substances and cause nuisance to mankind. Powder post beetles, the grubs of which cut the hard and dry wood, tunneling through timber in successive generations until the interior is completely reduced to fine packed powder. Silverfish. This insect is found in the neglected places on the walls. It feeds on a large variety of metals such as starched clothes, rayons, fabrics, bindings of books, and papers on which paste or glue has been used. Cockroaches. Cockroach is a common insect found in almost all houses. The insect is flat, brownish, and foul smelling. The cockroach produces foul smell on the foodstuffs by spreading its excreta. It also causes respiratory allergies and asthma. To summarize this topic and conclude, the insect pests which cause different types of damage to crops and domestic animals. Besides, they are known to act as vectors of diseases of human beings. The paper discusses the various types of injuries inflicted by harmful insects, particularly in the context of crop health management and human health management. Thank you.